In this video, you will learn how to perform more advanced heat calculations using the formula Q equals mC delta T. In the prior video, we learned how to use the formula Q equals mC delta T to solve for Q when given a mass of 25 grams, 4.18 joules per gram degree Celsius as the specific heat capacity of water, and 12 degrees Celsius for the change in temperature. But what if a question asks you to solve for the mass instead? Simply move all the variables that are on the same side as the mass to the bottom of the other side and then divide. Using the same numbers from above, we would put the 1254 joules of heat on top and divide that by the specific heat capacity of 4.18 joules per gram degree Celsius multiplied by the 12 degree change in temperature. After multiplying the bottom numbers together, your numerical setup should look like this so that when you divide, you get the mass of 25 grams. Solving for the specific heat capacity can be done the same exact way, except this time you would move the mass and the change in temperature to the bottom of the other side and then divide. Using the same numbers from above, we would plug in the values for heat, mass, and change in temperature. After multiplying the bottom numbers together, your numerical setup should look like this so that when you divide, you get the specific heat capacity of 4.18 joules per gram degree Celsius. As you probably guessed, solving for the change in temperature is done the same exact way, moving the variables found on the same side to the bottom of the other side and then dividing. After plugging in the values from above for Q, M, and C, and then doing the associated math, you will get the 12 degree change in temperature like you are supposed to. If you understand what just happened, please let me know by either liking this video or leaving a comment in the comment section below this video. Now, one more thing that you may be asked to do after finding the change in temperature is to then find either the final temperature or the initial temperature. Here's how to do that. The change in temperature is equal to the final temperature minus the initial temperature. So, if we know that the change in temperature is 12 degrees Celsius, and the question states that the temperature was initially at 24 degrees, what final temperature minus 24 would give you a change in temperature of 12 degrees? Just add 24 to both sides, and you get a final temperature of 36 degrees. Using the same formula, you can also figure out what the initial temperature is if you know how much the change in temperature is, and they give you the final temperature in the question. So, 36 minus what initial temperature would give you a change in temperature of 12? That's right, 24 degrees. Now, to really make sure you understand how to do basic and advanced heat calculations, here are three questions for you to try on your own. Once you've gotten your answers, you can then check to see if you did it right by clicking the link at the bottom of the video. Thank you for watching, and best of luck on your test.